Okay, guys, I'm going to show you how to use your calculator for your benchmark and your EOGs. And what we're going to do is we're going to do some just basic fraction problems. And I'm going to show you how to put them into the calculator here for me. So you're going to need to ask me for a calculator or get one out of the closet, and you're possibly going to need a sheet of paper. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you how to put in a mixed number. So I'm going to write 3. I'm sorry, upside down for you guys. 3. And a half. Plus 4 1/4. Now I know you can do this using a regular sheet of paper, but I'm also going to show you how to use the calculator. So we're going to start with the 4 1/4 first, okay? So you need to turn on your calculator. That's the first thing you do. To clear your calculator, you're going to hit the word clear and the on-off button. And you're going to click it, and it's going to say MEM cleared. That's going to give you a sign that it is cleared. Okay, to put the 4 in, you're going to hit the 4. Oh, I've got to turn it back on. 4. And then you're going to hit the word unit. That means that's a whole number. 4 is the unit. Then you have 1. And it gives you a part of the fraction. Now, to get to the bottom of the fraction, you're going to hit the N button. And you're going to hit the 4 again. So now you've just entered 4 1/4 into the calculator. Now you can hit the plus sign. Same thing here. You're going to hit 3. You're going to hit unit. You're going to hit 1, the N button, and the 2. And then you're going to be able to hit the equal sign. And when you hit the equal sign, you get 7 3/4. Now, say I give you a complicated problem. You could have done that in your head, no problem. Say I give you 14 7/8 plus 16 2/3. I could do that one again in my head. Why should I? Or not in my head, but I could do it in my, I could re-add it. But I'm going to do it here. So I want you to take a minute, hit 14. And then you're going to hit what button? The unit button. And then you're going to hit the 7. And then you're going to hit what button next? The N. And then you're going to hit the 8. Hit the plus sign. Hit 16. Hit the unit button. 2. Hit the N button. And 3. Now you can hit the equal sign. Now, this came up as 31 13/24. Now, I know that 13/24 cannot be reduced because 13 is a prime number. But if it could, what you could hit is there's a button right here called SIMP. The SIMP button, even if you don't know if it can be reduced, you can hit the SIMP button. It's going to have a little S, and you're going to hit enter again. If that number comes back up as the exact same answer, guess what? It's automatically simplified already for you. So sometimes you might need to do it. Now, say you have 31 13/24, and I know you won't have a calculator for your gridded response when we get to gridded response, but what you're going to have to do, if you have changed this fraction into a decimal, there's a button right here where it says F to a D. If you hit F to D, it automatically puts it into a decimal format for you. So right now, 31 13/24 is the same as 31.5416667. Okay. If I need to go back to a fraction, I hit the same button, and it puts me back at the 31 13/24. Okay. So once again, I'm going to clear that. I'm going to give you another problem here at, let's do, oops, wrong side, 16 1/5 minus 4 2/8. Okay. take a moment, plug it into your calculator, do 16 and 1/5 minus 4 and 2/8, please. And what you should get on your first screen is 11 and 38/40. Now, what you'll notice with this screen is it still can be simplified. So I'm going to hit the simplify button again. I'm going to hit the enter button. And I'm going to get 11 and 19/20. If I'm not sure that it can be reduced again, once again, I'm going to hit the simp button. And I'm going to hit the enter button again. It comes back up with the exact same answer as 11 and 19/20. Therefore, I know it's automatically simplified. If you'll do me a favor and hit the fraction to a decimal button, and now type in what this would be as a decimal. What you should have typed in is 11.95. That's what you should have typed in as your fraction to a decimal. Okay? What I would like right now for you to do, I'm going to give you one more problem. I'm going to give you a 38 3/4 -17 1/9. Now, yes, you could do this on your sheet of paper. Totally understandable. But once again, if you have the calculator, why not use it? So take a moment, add it, put it in, and then type in the answer that you get. And what I got here is 21 and 23/36. I'm going to hit the simplify button just to make sure. I think it is, but I don't know. And I get 21 and 23/36. Alrighty, so it was already simplified. Okay, right there. Once again, you've already had that answer. You could have done the butterfly. You could have done least common denominator, but if you have a calculator, why not try to use it? This might come in handy when you're working with an orders of an operation problem, and you're over here, and you're trying to do 3/4 times a number. You might need to be able to plug this into the calculator. Same thing happens that if you're trying to multiply a number, and I need to do 3/4 times 4 1/2. Okay, that's a 3, guys. I know it's the light here. 3 1/4 times 4 1/2. So once again, I'm going to hit the 4. I'm going to hit the unit. I'm going to hit the 1. I'm going to hit the n. I'm going to hit 2. And right there is my 4 1/2. I'm going to hit the multiplication sign. And then you're like, what happens if I don't want a mixed number? What if I just want a regular fraction? You don't have to hit the word unit. You hit the 3. I'm going to put 3/4 in. I'm going to hit the N button. It automatically makes a fraction here. And then I'm going to hit enter. And I'm going to get 3 3/8. Once again, I can hit the simplify button. And I can make sure that it is completely simplified. Okay. Same thing. If you don't know what you're doing in regards to plugging this into the calculator, please rewatch the video. Please go through this whole thing again, because you could do this on a sheet of paper. And what ends up happening on the EOG is that people get the calculator and they never use it. And then they're sitting there spending 20 minutes on one problem when they could have used the calculator. And I'm not saying the calculator is everything. I mean, it is the bomb diggity in regards to solving problems quicker. But in this class, you've learned mostly, for the most part, without a calculator, because if you can do it without a calculator, you can do it with a calculator. Instead of me taking me 20 minutes to do this problem, it took me 1 minute on the calculator. So it's just another tool that you are able to use in order to solve a problem quicker. So once again, please make sure that you have done this lesson with a calculator.